And I decree and declare prophetic, creative miracles in the spirit of provision, of finance, of opportunity. There's a harvest. There's lost souls. We've got to get our mind on the poor and the needy and the orphans and the homeless. And we've got to dedicate our lives to the saving of the lost. I decree and declare, may be. Come on, clap your hands and say, maybe. Maybe in my own life, God, may be. Miracles.
Jesus is the best thing, yeah,
that ever happened
to me.
Oh.
This morning, before it was morning and before the birds began to sing, I met the Lord, and the Lord said to me, you just better wake up that story about that Shunammite woman, lady. Because it's one thing to have things going well. It's another thing to believe that they're going to be well. And he said, you got to start doing like she did. You got to start looking at an ugly thing and saying, eh, it is well.
Yeah.
It is well. It is well. It is well. Let me tell you, when you start saying that, the enemy has got to back down. He's got to back down. All the turmoil that we go through, the crisis. We listen to the news and you can get sick to your stomach. Don't listen.
That's right.
Don't let it affect you. Something happens in the household, turmoil, strife. Look at that person back and say, you know what? Talk to the hand. It is well. It is well. It is well. Got a diagnosis? It is well.
Yes, Lord.
I'm speaking to Paula right now, who watches us from there in Massachusetts. Got a bad report on Monday. Went for a biopsy, agreed with us in prayer down here, was on our intercession, prayed with her, walked through the week with her. She kept saying, it is well, it is well, it is well. And then she got the documentation on Friday. Guess what it said? It is well. You gotta go through, Paula. You gotta go through. It is well. And let me tell you something, gals. Let me tell you something, mothers. And fathers, you could listen. When this Shunammite woman rode 32 miles on a donkey. 32 miles on a donkey. Not a stallion, not a thoroughbred, a donkey. Passed by her husband and said, where you going, woman? With a dead son on a bag.
Come on, preach.
Said to that man, you ain't my answer. Sorry, man, not my answer. It is well. You hear me? Got to the prophet, and Gehazi, the assistant, came out. Said, yes, what could I do for you? Said, I didn't come here to see you. Where is the prophet? The prophet brought this little boy into my house, and the prophet's going to bring him back.
Yes.
Let me tell you something. When trouble hits your home or your situation, don't take second best. Don't God start spilling your business on Facebook and Twitter. Don't accept no Gehazi. You go to the throne and not to Facebook. Don't go tweeting and Facebooking and ratting on what's going on in your family. You shut up and you start praying. Don't spill your business out there, because you know what? Those people are not for you to begin. They say, did you hear? Did you read Facebook today? That has become the verbiage now. Did you read Facebook? I don't have time. So-and-so is doing this. Don't tell me, because it is well. This year, 2012, it is going to be well. How many believe in that? This is our year of fulfilled prophecy. I don't care what it looks like. You get home today and you get on your Facebook, the first thing you're going to write is what? And what are you going to write? And what are you going to write? And you know what, devil? It's none of your business what I'm going through. I'm dressed with the Holy Spirit. It is well.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands.
Your hands.
If you are happy and you know it, clap your hands.
Your hands.
dope and do hopscotch and play jacks. And I said nursery rhyme. But now that I'm grown, there's one nursery rhyme that sticks out more than any other. You want to know what it is? Mary had a little lamb, little lamb. She had a baby boy.
About you, you can make a new decision about you. New information equals new decisions. Let me tell you, after my husband died, I was done. We had buried a daughter, a father, mother-in-law, father-in-law, five immediate family members, and when my husband was the last one, and when he died in my arms, and I had to get up and look at my 12-year-old son in the eye and try to heal him while I was good as a dead woman. And I wasn't fit to be a mama to my son in that condition because my son deserved at least one parent. I was driving down the road and I said, God, the thing I don't get about all this, I can't sense your direction. I don't know what to do. I've always been a woman that knew what to do. I'm a thinker. I'm a strategist. I always knew what to do. But after all of that, something so hurtful and painful and life-altering had hit my life in that last loss of my husband. So I said, God, I don't know what you're leading me to do. I've got this son that I absolutely worship and adore, but when I look in his eyes, I can't take the pain I feel for him. And my own pain, God, I don't. If you will just give me some direction, heaven was silent. I tried to manipulate God. I gave him all those scriptures. Lord, you said your sheep know your voice. I quoted everything back to God. Heaven was still silent. Can I just be honest and talk it real? Because that's all I'm about. I can't take that other stuff. And I felt like the Lord gave me a little phrase. Sister, here's what he said to me. He said, if you don't know where I am leading, L-E-A-D-I-N-G, if you don't know where I am leading, go where I am leaning. And I'm going to tell you something. Like a rider on a motorcycle, The bend in the road is not the end of the road unless you fail to make the turn. Oh, I'm leaning. I'm leaning. Just look at your neighbor and lean. I'm leaning. I can't tell you what I feel about this next move of God. I don't have faith for it. I would be lying if I said I did. But I can tell you one thing. I don't have 100% faith because it's so great, it's so magnificent, it's blowing my mind that it could be so good. But I have enough maybe. And God said to me, Jana, if I give you 80%, will you move on a maybe? You said, Jana, what if you fail? So what? I'll find another maybe. Nah. And I'll move out again. I'm not concerned about my faith because I'll know my faith will grow as I stay in the Word. My faith will grow as I stay in the right environment. But what I'm asking God now is the sap is flowing to the branches. And I have made up my mind. I will not live in reserve. I will not live in regret. And I will not live in retreat. I've got some witnesses in here. Now watch this. So, Jana, you're asking me to take a risk? Absolutely. Because a living dog is better than a dead lion. Even though we do our best to make informed choices. Now, if you're like me, I do all the research. I do a research, then I want to see a graph, then I want to see a pie chart. And then I want reports, and I want opinions. That's the way I am, because I want to make informed decisions. And don't bring me one answer, bring me multiple choice, and let me choose. So I like informed decisions. So sometimes, even though we like informed choices, unlike the Harvard studies, we have no history, no graphs, no data, but God said, I'm going to give you a hunch, a nudge, a maybe, and I expect you to move out on that. Many of us will have to change cities, change houses, change methods, change churches, change jobs, change careers, change plans, change management, change arrangements. We will have to change because understand, the word of the Lord to you is this, may be miracles. How many of you give me 10 minutes? Let me see your hand. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. I've got enough time. Thank you. In our text in the book of Esther, Esther 4:14, King Xerxes, he passed over 1,459 absolutely hand-chosen, drop-dead, beautiful, gorgeous women to get to Esther. The king passed over 1,459 women to get to Esther, to promote her, to look at her beauty, to give her favor, and to make her queen. What made her so different? Esther 4:14. Who knows the Message Bible? Maybe you have been made queen for such a time as this. She spent 12 months in worship. In other words, she was anointed with oil for 12 months, symbolic of worship. She was rubbed in oil. She desired a promotion with the king. So for 1 year of her life, she did everything within her power to present herself for an audience of one. She changed her raiment so that the king could see her desire to move into her future and not rehash the past. So she spent 12 months getting ready. She was rubbed and smeared in oil and spices. She learned the order of the kingdom. She learned protocol. She was willing to learn proper conduct and approach in the presence of the king. Why? Because she had a maybe. What are you willing to do because you have a maybe? You say, I really want this house to sell. Well, daughter, don't wait 2 or 3 years for the house to sell. Go clean out the closets. Put some bark out front and get some curb appeal going. Somebody say curb appeal. Clap your hands and shout amen. Don't wait until you get an IV and they roll you in the nursing home. Clean out that closet. Get those kitchen drawers cleaned out. Have yourself a yard sale. Are you willing to move on a maybe? God said, tell my people, this is leap year. And will you take a leap of maybe? I'm taking a leap of maybe. So Esther sought the wisdom of those who knew the king better than she did. The chamberlain came to her and asked her how she wanted to adorn herself. And here's what she said. You know the king. You know his colors. You know his fabric. You teach me. I want what the king wants. So the king passed over 1,459 bombshells to get to Esther. God honors risk takers. When arks are built, lives are saved. When soldiers march, Jericho's tumble. When staffs are raised, seas will open. When a lunch is served, thousands are fed. And when a garment is touched, even by the hem by an anemic woman in Galilee or the prayers of a beggar in Africa, Jesus stops, he stops, and he responds. I'm telling you, he responds to your leap of maybe. He will respond. Here's four principles I've learned from Esther, and I'm moving quickly. Number one, God has a special plan for your life. Esther was placed in a royal position, not by chance, but for a purpose. Maybe you've been made queen for this purpose. One of my favorite verses is Proverbs 16:9. In his heart, a man plans his course, but the Lord determines his steps. God didn't make a mistake when he made you today. I think we spend too long in our life trying to figure out what does God want me to be, and we don't enjoy the journey because we're so worried about the process. And we don't enjoy the journey. I'll tell you one thing. I'm a widow. I've raised a son. He didn't kill himself. He's not on drugs. Hallelujah. He's not strung out on alcohol this morning. He's just starting his sophomore year in college. Somebody say, thank you, sweet Jesus. I want to tell you something. Here's what I found out about God. When I realized God wants me to have abundant life, John 10:10, Jesus said, I am come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. One day I got in my car and I said, God, I've been worried about the ministry. I've been worried about reaching the nations. I'm worried about building more orphanages. I've been worried about my kids. They need rice. They need beans. They need education. They need dental work. They need doctors. My kids need everything, God. I wasn't praying for me and my son, praying for all the nations and the orphans. And I said, God, I'm burdened down with it. God said, my daughter, I want you to change the name of your ministry to We Don't Give a Rip Ministries. I said, okay, Lord, you'll take care of it. Clap your hands if you believe We Don't Give a Rip, because Jesus said, casting all your care upon me, for I care for you. Yes, he did. Oh, glory to God. The second thing I learned from Esther, sometimes you have to go against common sense, against what others advise, even against what you want, to follow God's plan. Esther would have to approach the king even though she did not have permission. I want to tell you one of my modes of operation. I went down to the hospital to visit and pray for the sick. And as I went into the ICU, the intensive care unit, they said, Ms. Alcorn, you have to wait. And this woman was dying, and I couldn't wait. And I said, I'm a minister, and I've got to get in there. She said, follow me. She took me down a corridor around some kind of service elevator. I don't know what it was, but I've never seen these in the hospital where she took me. She said, follow me. And then she stood and she pointed, and she was going to leave me at this point. I was going to be on my own. She said, do you see that door right there that says, do not enter? She said, walk right up to it, push it open, and keep going. I hear the word of the Lord say some of you have been restricted and you see doors that say do not enter, but God never said that. He said, you see that door? He said, you walk right up to it. You push your hand on it and you walk right through it, because this is a leap year and I'm taking a leap of maybe, and if I'm 80% sure, I'm going through my door. I'm going. Esther said, if I perish, I perish. I'm going through my door. The third thing, the time to follow God's plan is now. I find Esther 4:14 interesting. Back to Esther 4:14. If you remain silent at this time, relief and deliverance for the Jews will come from another place. But you and your father and your family will perish. And the Message Bible said, and maybe you have come to a royal position for such a time as this. Somebody said maybe. Ecclesiastes 11:4, if you wait for perfect conditions, you will never get anything done. Esther waited 3 days. Sometimes God said you can sleep today and tomorrow, but on the third day when you get up, I expect a decision. Number four, trusting in God completely brings great rewards. Esther 8:17, in every province and every city, wherever the edict of the king went, there was joy and gladness among the Jews. There was feasting and celebration because Esther saved a nation. Her obedience saved God's people from destruction. When was the last time you asked, God, what do you want to do through my life? Are you ready to ask God, what do you want me to do? Here's what the Spirit said to me. Jana, do you believe I'm all powerful? Yes, Lord, you're all powerful. Do you believe I have might? I said, yes, you're the mighty God. I believe you have might. He said, Jana, are you willing to join your maybe to my might? In other words, are you willing to attempt something or accomplish nothing? It would be wonderful if God gave you the very specifics. But what about this thought? Maybe this is what God wants me to do. What about this thought? Maybe this is God's direction. What about this thought? Maybe He's leading me. When is the perfect time for a maybe? I want to give you five times when you know you're at a maybe point. Number one, when everything else you tried did not work. Number two, when you know you don't want what you got. Number three, when frustrations have forced you into a passive existence. Number four, when the risk element of your life has been comatose. And number five, when you cannot shake the fact that there is still something ahead. Come on, somebody. I'm feeling that like a prophetic word. Noah did not wait for his ship to come in. He built a ship. Don't strike when the iron is hot, but make it hot by striking. Come on now. When you're in a moment that has the potential to alter your future, step out on a maybe. I feel like somebody needs to say amen to this white girl. Come on, say may. I'm one of them. How about you? Touch your neighbor. Say, you look like a maybe miracle. I'm so honored to be here this morning. You're so beautiful. Until your revelation becomes greater than your environment. Until your revelation becomes greater than your environment, you will always live a life of containment. Some of you have been seeking purpose to the exclusion of your environment. You have to have the right environment. See, I can give you a seed. And a seed on a shelf, how pretty. It's brown, it's round, it's just gorgeous. There's no defects, there's no blemishes. Look at this seed, and you put it on a shelf. It will never fulfill its purpose. But put the seed in the right type of soil. What happens? All the minerals start magnetizing to the seed to bring out the life. When you are in the right environment, God starts attracting to you everything you need for success, everything you need for kingdom dimension. It starts coming to your life because you become a seed that's planted instead of one that's on the shelf. That's a word. Clap your hands and say, maybe, 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 maybe. Maybe. Come on, don't stop. Just keep maybe. Come on, don't stop. Maybe. Maybe this is it, God. Maybe this is a time. Maybe this is what you're telling me. Maybe I've got an 80%. Come on, somebody with an 80%. Maybe. Maybe, God. Maybe I've walked the floors. I've worried, God, but maybe. 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 Now we're going to make a decree, and we're going to decree and declare. And Pastor Lynn Bracco, I prophesy over you. woman of God, the weight upon thy shoulders would be dissipated in the month of May. For God said unto this house, May be miracles. And I decree and declare prophetic, creative miracles in the spirit of provision, of finance, of opportunity. There's a harvest. There's lost souls. We've got to get our mind on the poor and the needy and the orphans and the homeless. And we've got to dedicate our lives to the saving of the lost.
Hey, I trust you've enjoyed our program today. We want it to be a blessing to you. We want it to be a point of contact where you could receive all that the Lord has for you. I've got good news for you. If you'd like to have a CD or a DVD of this entire program, we only gave you a small portion, just call the number on your screen and we'd be glad to send it to you for just a small donation. Whatever the donation is, it doesn't matter. All proceeds go into our food pantry where we feed the hungry week after week here. Love you. Want to bless you. Call the number on your screen if you want prayer. We have prayer counselors filled with love and the power of God. Would love to come in agreement with you. God bless you until we see you again.